My name is Emily Busch, and I am the Nipponkan Vice President and AHAN International Program Director. I journeyed to Takalon, Thailand in June to visit the AHAN Belay House Orphanage. The purpose of this visit was to research the purchase of adjoining property for the building of a Karen Tribe Traditional Heritage Center. On this trip, I brought 30 uniforms for the Belay House Children's Choir. These uniforms were provided through a spring fundraising seminar instructed by Homa Kancho at the Nipponkan General Headquarters in Denver. I taught the children English with games, and we all had a very good time together. I also visited the Wei Pak Community Church built by Homa Kancho in a neighboring village and nearby United Nations refugee camp on the border between Thailand and Myanmar. After leaving Thailand, I flew to Myanmar. The first stop was a visit to the town of Sitwe in the Rakhine State near the Bangladesh border. Accompanying me was Mr. Yu Thon Ong, father of AHAN Myanmar coordinator Nilar Thon, who is a distinguished retired newspaper editor in his own right. Mr. Thon is also the principal of the AHAN Myanmar Learning Center in Yangon. We traveled to Sitwe to check on the Mahatini Buddhist temple, where AHAN has been rebuilding a dormitory facility for orphan children living there. We were there to attend the opening ceremony of the new dormitory, as most of the work had been completed. Accompanied by Nilar Thon, AHAN Myanmar coordinator, and family, we delivered our monthly supply of rice and other supplies to the Yadnapon Temple and Orphanage and joined the children for a midday meal. Last year, in partnership with the Yadnapon Temple in Yangon, AHAN Nipponkan built the AHAN Jangon Learning Center. In the afternoon, I visited the AHAN Myanmar Learning Center in Yangon and held an English question and answer session with students currently studying for their entrance examinations into the universities. The purpose of this learning center is to house, teach, and prepare students from the countryside, from all backgrounds and all tribes for entrance into Yangon universities. All of the students at the AHAN Myanmar Learning Center would never have had the means to be able to study at the university level on their own. To date, dozens of these students have successfully entered local universities in the Yangon area.